folks, to tonight's game. This one promises to be a good one between the Texas Tech Red Raiders and the Oklahoma Sooners. And before we go any further, let's check in on our Star Watch, Dick. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
Wow, Brad. Look at the matchup at the small forward position. That's the price of admission itself. Two skilled players who can really play.
And the referee is ready to toss it up. Early in the ball game, these two teams try to set their particular tempo. The Sooners are currently ranked number 17 in the nation, Dick.
When you go up against a ranked team, Brad, it's extra incentive for the lower-ranked or non-ranked team to get fired up.
Dick into the offensive set now, and let's see what we'll look at here with a 3-2.
Well, you know, the 3-2 offense, 3-2 set, really can be effective in getting a lot of cutting and screening, especially effective in attacking the basket and getting right down the lane. Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Time to pick up the defense here now. Goes up. Nails the jumper. Cross court. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Off the mark. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Buries the fadeaway.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Working it around the perimeter. Goes up with a shot. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically 1 against 5. Not good odds.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Missed the jumper. Cross court. For two. Off the glass and no good. The crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Inside. He tries the three. Busts the J. Well, you know, basketball was like nutrition, Dick. His game would be broken down into the two major food groups, and that's passing and score.
Hey, when a scorer is able to read and react to pressure like this, holes start showing up in the defense.
Cross court. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
The Red Raiders now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Lobs it. Goes up for two. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Cross court. He looks for three and come up short. Trying to pack it inside. Number 10 picks up the foul. Second team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
As we take a look at the sophomore.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches. Can. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
He may be in some trouble here.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. The missed shot. Evan receives the ball. Working around the perimeter. In the lane. They got it. The Sooners prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times and then really settling in the half court at other times.
Brad, they like the balanced attack. They don't feel like they can always play up-tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think this style works for them.
Takes his jumper. They get it to go.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
On the dribble. Gives it up. Now the turnaround jumper. Nope. Rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
On the right side. From way outside. Off the mark. Evans receives the pass. On the outside. Jumper. Can't connect. Young handles the pass. Cross court. From the corner, he misses the fadeaway. He gets the rejection. Number 23's inferior play is really affecting his composure now.
He needs to take a deep breath, refocus, and get after it.
Cross court. Count the hoop. That's goaltending. That one went through the high post, Dick.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice. Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
Number 54 is charged with the foul. Second team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful.
And he got them both. They work the perimeter. And now the fadeaway jumper. Off the mark. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For three. Gets the J to fall. The Red Raiders got some good ball reversal there.
I tell you, they're really playing some great basketball. Just a quality possession right there. They're moving the basketball, reversing the ball. That's really great to watch.
He gets it to fall. Tries for two. Gets it to fall. A great drive to the hoop right there, Dick.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
And we're at the 8-minute mark. Goes up with it. Nails a sweet jumper. The Sooners have put together a real team effort so far, Dick.
It really takes the pressure off of your go-to guys when the supporting cast is able to make plays, rebound, and be strong on defense. As a coach, when your team is playing together like this, you have to be smiling on the sideline.
For the bucket. Great shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards that they have.
Yeah, that helps. About 7 minutes remaining. For two, drains the shot. Dick, they're really running their offense through the high post right now.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a gold mine if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
Number 23 gets the pass. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. You betcha. They'll work it around the arc. Tries for two. He nails the shot. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
Great recognition by both players. The backdoor cut is one of those types of plays you love to see.
6 minutes left on the game clock. He pulls up with a jumper. Jumper won't go.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the bucket. He can't get the bucket to fall. Cross court. He goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the right side. Outside jumper. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. They look to get it to the inside. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Scorches the net. Dumps it in. Goes up for two. He misses it. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Comes up empty. Gave it up. Number 20 is... He took it hard to the rack and got the foul.
Well, that's what his coach likes to see. His boys going hard to the hole and not settling for the jump shot.
And here's a look at the first-year play.
You know, playing at this level can be a tough adjustment for some kids. Others make the jump look easy. It all depends on what kind of team you have around you and how hard you are willing to work to get better.
We're at the four-minute mark. The small forward receives the ball. He shoots the jumper. And nice-looking jumper in the lane. There's a double team waiting there. The power forward gets the pass. Kicks it out.
Great shot block right there. And some good movement on the offensive side.
Cross court. From the corner, knocked it down. We're at the three-minute mark. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Silly mistake.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from right of the circle. Missed the jumper. He makes the block. Loose ball. Great play. He dribbles the ball out of bounds. Young has been on a mission out there today, Dick.
I tell you, it's been a treat to watch him out there. He understands what he needs to do, which occasionally means taking a shot and other times looking for his team.
We're at the two-minute mark. Cross court. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Looking for a good shot. Puts up the tray. And come up short. The shooting guard handles the pass. He puts up the J. Missed it. And the slam. That's a great drive to the basket.
He had one thing on his mind, and that was getting to the goal. Mission accomplished.
Tries one from three-point land. He misses the fadeaway. On the outside. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
About a minute remaining. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. The small forward receives the ball.
Up and inside.
With the J.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Shot clock is dead. Cross court. For two. No good from the field. Four is whistled for the foul. Fourth team foul.
Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Two at the charity stripe. He shoots from long range. Off the mark. At the half, the Sooners lead by six. Our game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Hamilton checks in the game again.
Hey, always interesting to see how players respond after a bit of a breather.
It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
They work it around the perimeter. Puts up the J. Scores it.
Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Nope. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He rejects it. He wants it, and he saves it. Cross court. Shoots from the corner. Bust the J.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Seconds. A little two-man action. Can he beat the buzzer? Off the mark. Jumper won't go. Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. The shot won't fall. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
A little half-court action, a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
On the baseline, he strokes it. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Out on the wing. Puts up the jumper. There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping.
Inside. Stolen away. The small forward gets the pass. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Nails the jumper. They're working around the perimeter. On the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
They go into the low block. Here comes the ball screen. Gave it up for the bucket. Got it. That one went through the high post, Dick.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a goal line if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
Out on the right wing. On the outside. He shoots from the deep corner.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Inside. For two. Off the glass and no good. They work the perimeter. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Kicks it out. Takes the jumper. Nails the J. It up. At least bad shots have a chance of going in. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really work with one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel involved.
Zone offense now. On the left side. Goes up for two. Tickles a twine. We take a look here at each team's tempo, Dick.
Hey, the key to this game is not just who will set the tempo, but who can control it throughout the game.
Cross court. From the top of the circle.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on a perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
Misses the first shot. Misses them both. He takes the rebound. On the left side. He unloads a three. Missed the jumper. Way out on the right wing. Had to go up high with a shot. He misses the fadeaway. Young handles the pass. And score it. On the dribble, gives it up. Obvious foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets. Good teams will get to the line looking, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws. He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
He puts up the tray. That was nice. The shooting guard takes the feed. There's the pick. Ten to shoot now. Goes up with a shot. Gets the J to fall. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's a question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Baseline from the corner. The missed shot. Out on the right wing. Now trying to feed the low block. The turn, a fadeaway jumper. Nope. Pushes it up. The Red Raiders are one of only a handful of schools who have that father-son combination on the bench.
It's what I call keeping it in the family. Basketball is in the family's genes. It's their passion.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
Hey, this place is remarkable. The noise is deafening.
Gave it up. He tries the jumper. Off the mark. Alley-oop.
That was a beautiful alley-oop. He called for it and then went up and put it down. Picture perfect, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. We're at the 7 minute mark. Smith receives the ball. They'll work it around the arc for the bucket. The Sooners are going to have to transition into playing strictly a half court style now.
At this point, playing in the half court would be a wise move. They don't really need to score, but do need for time to come off the clock.
The Red Raiders are looking at an uphill battle now, Dick. One thing they should consider doing is increasing the tempo.
They'll need some quick scores.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
It's important that you've got bench players who can contribute just in case the starters have kind of an off night.
It seems like everyone's getting involved, Brad, which is great. They're playing together, which is making things difficult for the defense.
inbound from the baseline. Down inside for two. Goes. Hamilton handles the feed. Jump hook from the low post. Gave it up. 6 minutes left on the game clock. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. The layup is good. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
When the defense plays too aggressive, those types of passes are going to be open.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Minutes left in the game clock. Trying to feed inside. Swatted away. Number one with the ball.
Pushing that basketball.
The student body is rocking tonight.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Missed it.
To go inside.
Whistle and a foul. He gets the tough layup and a foul to go with it, Dick.
Hey, that was awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
He hits it. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
On the right side. Puts it up. Nails a sweet jumper. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Knocks it down. Out on the wing. Turnaround jumper. He had his shot blocked. Looking for a good shot. Yes! Cross court. He shoots from the baseline. Scorches the net with a J. Now they work it around the perimeter. We're at the 3 minute mark. If everyone else is covered, give it to the guy in the stands. Hamilton taking it hard to the hoop. What a great take there.
Hey, up, up, up and away, Mr. Nestler. That's how you go strong to the basket.
Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the corner. Misses from three-point land. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
He pulls up with a jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the outside. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. Tries for two. He drains it. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it will come down to in this game.
He goes for three. Rims out. And the block. We'll stay right here. The long ball has really been falling for him, Dick.
Hey, something has gotten into these guys. They've been great from deep, Brad. They've been shooting the ball with confidence. This is great to watch. These guys are on fire.
Inbound on the baseline. Goes up. He misses the J. The small forward with the ball. Buried it. Cross court. About a minute remaining. He attempts a three. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
Evans receives the ball. Jumper won't go. He shoots from the corner. He buries it. Time out on the floor, folks. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. Time out on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
Well, I think at this juncture, it's important that the players on the court are all communicating. This is a message that the coaches will likely convey to their players. Everyone realizes that the margin for error is small and that paying attention to the details is the most important at this point. Let's see what happens.
Well, Dick, it's always important to come out of a timeout with a game plan, I think.
You know, very important. It's a chance to get your team on the same page, talk about what's happened previously and what's about to happen in the future. I hate it when teams come out of a timeout unorganized and without a plan.
About ready to hit the floor. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Shot clock is dead. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And he's charged with his last foul.
They come too quick sometimes.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul. stops the clock again. Young goes to the line for the first time. Just like in practice. Makes his second shot.
Gotta get one on this possession, baby.
Action's ready to start again.
Up and inside.
He unloads a three. Can't connect. Well, before we go any further, let's see who came in as our players of the game today.
Only one will walk away with the win, but both these kids gave it everything they had, and it was great to watch them compete.